Students, welcome to Global Online University. So I'm very excited to tell you that we have launched a mock test series for you all. Every day at 8 a.m. we will be uploading this mock test, and we have planned to upload 40 such mock tests till your examination, which will be a total of 2000 MCQs. So we will be covering your entire syllabus through this mock test series at least 3 to 4 times before the examinations. Each mock test is going to have 50 questions from different unit, and if you watch all the videos of this series, you are likely to get 70 to 80 marks in your paper 1. Why you should give this mock test? First of all, this is a very good preparation assessment for you. It helps you to know whether you have prepared well for paper 1 or not. For students who have just started their preparation, these mock tests are enough for your preparation, because we will be covering your entire syllabus multiple times before the examination. Every unit and every topic will be covered. For students who have already prepared for paper 1, it is a very good revision for you all. So there are certain rules while giving this mock test. When a question appears on the screen, pause the video and try to answer this. Anyways, we have all explained it in the video. There is 2 marks for each question, and the exam is total of 100 marks. If you are scoring between 40 and 60, your score is average, and you need to give a lot more attention to paper 1. But if you are scoring between 60 and 80, your score is good, but you need to give a little attention. While if you are scoring 80 and above, your score is outstanding, and now you can focus on paper 2. So if you are scoring between 40 and 60, a lot more attention is required. If you're scoring between 60 and 80, a little ICT. And the first question is, what is the full form of IoT? So IoT means Internet of Things. The right answer is option C. So IoT means it is the physical network where different objects, they are connected because they have sensors, softwares and technologies. For instance, these days you can operate your air conditioner also with your mobile. Also, there are so many things that are connected. For example, your smartwatch, they are connected to your mobiles. Whenever there is a message on the mobile, you can see it on your smartphone. What is all this? All these is Internet of Things, because there are certain physical objects that have sensors, software and technology which help them to communicate with each other. So that is IoT, Internet of Things. It helps with wireless communication of different objects. A digital signature is called a digitally scanned signature, handwritten signature, encrypted information or verbally communicated message. So a digital signature is a encrypted information. It means like there are certain digital documents that you want to send. So what do you do it? You put a digital signature on it. So when it is received by the receiver, if the digital signature is valid, it means that the information that was inside it has not been altered while transmission. So the right answer is option C. It is an encrypted information. That means if it goes in the network, nobody is able to break it or change it. Okay, so here the right answer is C. Where does a computer add and compare its memory? It's data. So you know, compare a computer, it is responsible for modification of data. It works on data. So this comparison is done where? In the computer. So it is done in the CPU. So CPU, it consists of, there are 3 components of CPU: control unit, ALU logical unit and memory unit. So this comparison is done by the ALU, which is inside CPU. So in these 4 options, the right answer is option A. Comparison of data is done by CPU. Bandwidth of data communication is a measure of its physical dimension, data communication capacity, electrical parameters or physical strength. So bandwidth of data is the data communication capacity. We say Gbps per second. What is gigabytes per second? These are data communication capacity, which is the bandwidth of data. Which malicious program cannot do anything until actions are taken to activate the file attached by the malware? So malware If you have not heard of this term, malware is related to software. Like software, they are useful to do some kind of task like a web browser. But malware are those software whose main intention is to harm your computer. Okay, so malware are softwares which are intended to harm a particular computer. So which malicious program cannot do anything until actions are taken to activate the files? So here the answer is option C. There are different types of malware. So virus is those malware which cannot do anything until you open the file. Okay, if there is a virus in certain file, like file 1, unless and until you open this file, nothing will happen to the computer. But as in when you open it, your computer will become infected. While worms, on the other hand, worm is also a kind of malware, but these do not require human intervention. Without human intervention also, they are able to transfer from one computer to the other. Okay, so virus require you to put some action, or you need to open the file, only then it will get infected. The tags placed on animals to record and track in a database all of the animal movements are known as RFID. The right answer is option B. RFID stands for radio frequency identification. So these tags are used to see where the animals are. Sometimes they are also used to calculate the number of animals or count in a place. A computer program that directly translates a program statement by statement into machine language is called. So this question is very important, I must tell you, because every year in one of the examinations it will come regarding program translation. So interpreter is the program that translates a computer program into machine language. You know that computer do not understand your language or my language, they understand only binary language, and humans, they understand high level languages. English language we understand. So we have formed a high level language which is like English. This helps you to code. So this English language has to be converted into binary language. The task of conversion from high level language to binary language is done by a translator. So there are different types of translator. Language translators are there. A compiler, there is compiler, but why the answer to this question is interpreter and not compiler? Because interpreter does this task statement by statement. Okay, while compiler, it translate one code into another at once. Okay, the whole code is translated at once, but interpreter, it goes line by line. It will translate one statement, then other statement, like this it will go on. So if this line is written instead of saying a program and one go, agar question ye bolta hai ki ek computer program jo directly translate karta hai program ko in one go, if the question might have said in one go, then the answer would be compiler. But if the question says statement by statement or line by line, mark the answer as D. Read the following two statements. Okay, so there are two statements given in this question, and you have to tell if both are correct or neither are correct, or if second is correct, or if first is correct. So ICT is considered as a subset of IT. So this statement is incorrect because it is the opposite that is correct. ICT is the bigger circle. This is ICT and IT is the subset of ICT. Okay. And it is not the vice versa. So this is incorrect while this is correct. IT is the subset of ICT. Okay. The right to use a piece of software is termed as copyright. So this statement is correct. Hence, option C is the right answer. Only second statement is correct. What is the full form of the abbreviation CD-ROM? So you might have heard about CD-ROM. We have used it extensively. CD-ROM stands for Compact Disk Read-Only Memory. The right answer is option C over here. Why it is read-only memory? Because we cannot change it. The manufacturer, they write it once and we cannot make any changes to read-only memory because it says read-only. That is why it can be only read and not written. Right answer is C. Multimedia comprises of. So, what does a multimedia comprise of? Audio, text, video, audio. Video only or text, audio, video. So, a multimedia comprises of all these things. Multi means many and media means the medium of communication. So, if you are using multiple mediums of communication, you are using text also, audio also, video also, all these things if you are combining multiple mediums, if you are using, it is called multimedia. For example, slides you see, PowerPoint slides, they are a very good example of multimedia. Next question is, information and communication technology comprises of online learning, learning through mobile application, video-based learning, or all of the above. So, ICT, information and communication technology comprises of all these above. Online learning as well as learning through mobile application, also video-based learning. So, all these are the right answer. Python is a programming language, operating system, search engine, or snake. So, you might have heard about programming language. These languages are used to write computer codes. So, Python is a kind of a programming language. Also, Python is a kind of a snake. It is a very poisonous snake. So, A and D are right answer to this question. Okay, next question. Which type of memory holds the computer startup routine? So when the computer starts, which memory is responsible, which has all the information about the computer startup? So that is ROM. ROM stands for read-only memory. So there is a program called BIOS that is embedded inside the ROM. It means basic input-output system. So it has all the information about booting. Booting means when you click the power button of the computer and when the desktop appears on the screen, or the time frame that happens between 30 seconds or 1 minute. So at that time, booting process is done, which is done by BIOS program, which is inside the ROM. Okay, so ROM, read-only memory, it holds the computer startup information. Next question. Given below are two statements, one is assertion and one is reason. Now we have to tell if both are true but R is not the correct explanation, or if both are true and R is the correct explanation of A. If A is true but R is, A is false but R is true, or if A is true but R is false. So once I have told you, now going forward I will not tell you about these options. Okay, there are multiple assertion and reason in this video. Okay, so the first statement, that is assertion, it says total number of mobile users are increasing rapidly. Yes, this statement is true because you know, we know nowadays every a small child or an elderly person, everybody is using a mobile phone. So the total number of mobile users are increasing, right? So this is correct. Let's look at the reason. The cost of mobile is decreasing. Yes, this is also very true. 15 years ago, the simple mobile that had only buttons, it used to cost 10 to 15,000 rupees. But now we get smartphone also in the range of 8,000 or 5,000. So the cost of mobile is decreasing or has decreased. That is why the number of mobile users have increased. So here both are correct and reason is the correct explanation of the assertion. Okay, both A and R are true and R is the correct explanation of A. Okay, B is the right answer. The file extension of MS Word document in Office 2007 is So file extension or file formats are very important for your exam perspective. Do study them for your paper one. File extension of MS Word document is docx, docx. From MS Word 2007 or Office 2007 and above, docx has been started to use. Before that, only doc was used, but now docx is used. What is the binary of number 9? So this conversion from decimal to binary, this number is a decimal number, right? 9. How will you convert it to binary? First, what do you do if such a question comes? Write a number like this, okay? And make two lines like this. Now, write 2 over here. Divide this by 9. Divide 2 by 9. So what will be the quotient? Quotient will be 4 and the remainder will be 1. Okay? 2 fours are 8 and remainder will be 1. Again, divide 2 by 4. You will get quotient 2, remainder 0. Then again, divide 2 by 2. You will get quotient 1 and remainder 0. So here, but whenever you are writing the answer will be in reverse order. Okay? 1, 0, 0, 1. In this situation, if you write 1, 0, 1, that is also true. But if like this, if it is the answer 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. So the answer will be 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay? And not opposite. It will not be the opposite. So here the answer is option B, 1001. When you are converting decimal to binary, just write the number, keep on dividing it by 2, write the quotient here and the remainder at the side. While answering, write it in the reverse order from bottom, go upwards, and you will get the answer. Decimal to binary is very simple. What is the full form of bias? So in previous slide, I have told you if there was one question about which memory holds the computer startup routine. For that question, the answer was ROM. So in that question, I did tell you about BIOS. So BIOS stands for Basic Input Output System. So this is the program that contains all information about computer start. How is the computer going to communicate with the hardware? All that information is stored in is all this information is done by the BIOS program. The full form of it is Basic Input Output System. Computer hardware consists of computer table, monitor and CPU, software and Google. So computer hardware are those computer devices that can be touched. Okay, so you can touch a mouse or a monitor or a CPU, but you cannot touch a software because software are programs that you cannot touch. Google, it is a website that is also not a computer hardware, and computer table. So this is not a computer hardware. You cannot say computer table is a hardware or computer cover is a hardware. That will not come in hardware, okay? Computer hardware are those devices which can be touched. For example, keyboard, mouse. One is labeled as assertion and the other is the reason. Assertion says, nowadays many online courses are available and their popularity is increasing. Reason is, selecting a right course from many such is a big challenge. So here, this is true. Online courses that are available are continuously increasing. But the reason is not right. The reason should be why these are online courses are increasing or their popularity is increasing. So individually, this statement is correct that choosing a right course is very difficult because there are so many options, but it is not the correct explanation of assertion. So here the right answer is option A. AF system is used in which number system? So binary number system, it consists of zeros and ones. So the base to binary number system is 2. For octal, the base is 8. So there you have numbers from 0 to 7. Okay, hexadecimal is the number system which has 16 as the base. Okay, so 16 is the base where You have numbers from 0 to 9, and then you have letters from A to F. So total there are 16, 10 numerals and 6 alphabets. That is why the base is 16. Decimal is between 0 and 9 and the base is 10. So the number system that has A and F, you can see clearly from the screen, is option C. The following storage devices: hard disk, CD-ROM, DVD-ROM. Now arrange this in ascending order of storage capacity. Ascending order means smaller to bigger. So the least or which storage device that has least capacity is CD-ROM. Then is DVD, and the highest capacity is hard disk. So the answer is 2, 3 and 1. Option A is the right answer. Okay. Is the right answer here. Which of the following is not suitable in the context of email? The question says which is not suitable. So it is a letter sent over a computer network. Yes, this is true. It is used to send unsolicited messages. Yes, this is true. For students who do not know the meaning of unsolicited, it means that unsolicited means anchaha, that is not wanted. So there are so many advertisements that you get on your email, if you might have seen. So that are called unsolicited messages. Email address include a domain name. Domain name like .com or .edu. All these are domain name, or which is added at the end of the email address. So which statement that is not true is email is a snail mail. So option C is incorrect. Next question. A virus type that is capable of shifting from one computer to another without user interaction is known as a worm. So here, by chance, if the option would have been virus, at that time also you would not have selected virus, because virus requires human activation. If there is a software or a file, you will have to open it, only then virus will come. But worm are a kind of malware who do not require human interaction. Without interaction also, it has the power to go from one computer to the other and infecting all the computers. A confidential file needs to be deleted from a workstation. What is the most effective way to ensure it? So there is a confidential file. Confidential file means a secret file which you want to delete. If you rename the file, that is also not a good option, because anyways it is going to be there in the computer. Compress the file and backup. Oh, backup means you are keeping it safe on the tape. So that is also not a good option. Copy and paste the file into the recycle bin and empty the recycle bin. So if you copy and paste it, there will be a original file already present even if you empty the recycle bin. But if you drag the file into the recycle bin and then delete it, then the file will be deleted permanently. So D is the most effective way or the best way to delete a confidential file. In a computer related activities, what is the full form of worm? So worm means write once and read many. So there are many examples of a worm like CD. Read write, it means, so read write once, read many, it means there are certain type of storage devices which are written once but they can be read many times. You remember we used to, in like 10-12 years ago, we used to bring CDs to watch movies. At that time, those kind of CDs that were written once, only once data was written on it, but it could be run many times because the manufacturer used to put a film on that CD, but you had the opportunity to read it as many times as you want to read it. Okay, so that is the full form of a worm. Do not confuse it with malware. That is a different thing. Here worm means write once and read many. So in computer related activities, which of the following is inappropriate for describing a language translator? So in one of the questions, we talked about interpreter, that is a language translator. Assembler is also a language translator. It is used to translate assembly language. And compiler is used to translate high-level languages, and so is interpreter. But codec is not a kind of language translator. Okay, so interpreter translates your program in statement by statement, while compiler does it in one go. And assembler is also a kind of language translator. A very important question. Which of the following is the most suitable for being designed as fourth generation language? So the fourth generation language is Java. So here the right answer is option B. Okay. Assertion and reason question again. So assertion says sniffing may be used to steal data or information over a network. Yes. So sniffing, it is a term which is used to describe the data packets that are going to a network to read or to get data from those packets. That is known as sniffing. Reason is, sniffing is a process of monitoring and capturing all data packets passing through the given network. Yes, this is also true. So in this question, the right answer is option B. Because both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of assertion. You might have also heard of the term phishing. Phishing is also a computer term which is important. It means deliberately there are sites which want you to write your personal information so that they can misuse it. So that is phishing. But sniffing is some data is going on over the network, and to steal those data, that is called sniffing. So select the options that allow only optical storage media. So in this question, optical storage media, if you look at this, is the right answer is DVD, digital versatile disk. CDR means CD recordable, Blu-ray disc, and CD read-write. So optical storage media means it uses light to write data on it. So USB, it is not optical storage media. So here this is incorrect. Here in this question also. So here, this statement is also incorrect. Here hard disk is there. That is why this option is incorrect. Okay. Next question. This is a match the following question. Students, I would like to tell you that these days match the following has been asked extensively. So study these for your examination. It is very important. Blogging. So blogging is a kind of a social media. A3, okay. Then television. Television is a kind of electronic media. Periodicals is a kind of a print media, while collection of site is World Wide Web. So the answer is 3124. 3124. D is the right answer. One more information. This is a question from communication unit, but you see, all the units are connected as well. This question is a very good question because they have asked you communication unit as well as ICT in one single question. A beautiful question. Blogging is a kind of social media because you write blogs and people are able to read it, share it. Television is an electronic media. Periodical is print media, while collection of sites is World Wide Web. That is www. One more question is match the following question. So here the options are 50 into decimal, 102 in decimal, real time video conferencing, SMS, texting. So before solving it, let's see first we will solve this. Maybe we'll get the answer. Real time video conferencing is synchronous communication. Yes. Because synchronous communication is when those people, those are communicating, they are present at the same time. But in asynchronous, they are present in different time. SMS texting is a kind of asynchronous media. Also, email is an example of asynchronous media. So now the options that are left, so the answer should be C should be 3 and D should be 4. C 3 and D 4. So here you see, this has C 3 and D 4. So that means now you will have to solve one of these to get the answer. Okay, because two options has this same. So when you will solve these, what is the decimal? 15 decimal is how much in binary? Let's solve, as I already told you in one of the question, how to solve decimal to binary. Divide 2 by 50, write the question 25, the remainder will be 0. Again, divide 25 by 2, the remainder will be 12. Quotient will be 12 and remainder 1. 2 6s are 12, remainder 0. 2 3s are 6, remainder 0. 2 1s are 2 and remains a 0. So the answer is 2 25 2 12 2 6 0 2 3s are 6 remainder 0 2 1s are 2 remainder 0. So actually remainder will be 1. Okay, 2 1s are 2 and remainder will be 1. So here the as I told you, the answer is should be written in the reverse order. 110010. Okay, so let's see which is the answer. 110010. So 15 decimal is this much in binary. So A should be 1. A 1. So here the answer should be C, because A is 1 and B is 2. For your information, I'll just solve 102 also. How to solve 102? Divided by 2, the remainder will be 51 and the remainder will be 0. 225, remainder 1. 212, remainder 1. 26, remainder 0. 23, remainder 0. 21, remainder 1. So here it will be 110010110. So the answer is 102 is this much in binary. Okay. Now you will be able to convert decimal to binary. Very simple. Okay. Next question. Assertion says blog is a form of social media. Yes, this is true. A blog allows anyone to communicate to a public audience. Yes, this is also true. So, in this question, both are correct. Assertion and reason are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. So, B is the right answer. Next question. Again, assertion and reason. IT is fast becoming a very important field of activity in India. Yes, this is true. You know, there are so many companies in India, IT companies, TCS, Infosys, Wipro, there are like thousands of IT companies. Software, the reason says software is one of the major export of India, and further India has strong base in hardware. No, the reason is incorrect, because we are usually better at providing services to other companies. So there are less number of product-based companies as service-based company. So we are not exporting software, and India does not have a very good base with hardware. So reason is incorrect. In this question, only assertion is true. A is true and R is false. Okay, right answer is D. Which of the following is major issue arising out of growing reliance on information technology? Yes, security threats are increasing. There is cyber attacks also. Now there are hackers who are able to get money from your bank account. So security threat is there. Also, there are privacy concern, there are people who can misuse your photos that we put on social media. So privacy concern is there, but there is nothing related. Profitability issue is not there with IT. So here in this question, the major issue is only B and C. Again, match the following question. So there is list one and list two. VOIP. VOIP stands for Voice Over Internet Protocol. So it is used for making calls over the internet. So VOIP, if you match, this will be second. Fiber optic cable. So optic means light. First option says make use of light pulse to transmit data. So here first option is correct for this. URL. URL is text used by web browsers. Yes, you might have seen HTTP colon slash google.com. That is URL. So that is text used by web browsers. And UTP cable. UTP stands for unshielded twisted pair cable. It is used as a form of LAN, extensively in the form of LAN, that is used for connecting small buildings. So here the answer should be 2143. Let's see, 2143. B is the right answer over here. Select the option that includes file format suitable for distributing sound files across the internet. So for transferring sound files, we have different file formats. We have already discussed image, video, audio, and text or program files. But for sound files, we use option D. WMV is Windows Media Video. It is a video file. While WMA, it is a Windows Media Audio. It is an audio file. AVI is also a audio video interleave. MIDI stands for musical instrument digital interface. WAV stands for audio file. WAV is a kind of audio file format. So here MP3, it is one of the most famous audio file formats. So the right answer is option D. Which of the following communication technologies employ only asynchronous communication? Video conferencing, email, forums, instant messaging. So asynchronous communication means people who are communicating are present at different space and time. So here the answer is email and forums, B and C, because video conferencing is synchronous communication and instant messaging is also a kind of synchronous communication. Okay, so if they talk about asynchronous communication, email is a kind of asynchronous, and forums are asynchronous communication. Okay. In a computer, a byte consists of 1 byte is equals to 8 bits, and 1 nibble is equals to 4 bits. Which of the following is a type of virus? So, internet worm is a type of virus. It does not require human interaction for spreading from one computer to the other. MOOC, it stands for Massive Open Online Course. So, it is a platform where our online courses are available for everyone for free. Which of the following is not a search engine? So, search engine is a kind of service that allows you to search documents on the World Wide Web. So Chrome is not a search engine because Chrome is a web browser. While the question asked about search engine, Google is a search engine, Yahoo is a search engine, and Bing is also a kind of search engine. Chrome is a web browsers. So web browsers are programs that helps you to access the internet. Which of the following represents 1 billion characters? So if the question asks about 1 million characters, students, remember it is going to be megabyte. If it asks about 1 billion characters, it is going to be gigabyte. And if the question asks about 1 trillion character, it is terabyte. So remember M for million, T for trillion, but this you will have to remember. 1 GB or 1 GB is equals to 1 billion characters. C is the right answer. Which of the following is not an open source software? So open source softwares are those softwares which under a particular license they are given to a person, and then they have the power to make changes to it, make modifications, and they can also distribute it to the others. So those are open source, which according to a particular license, they have the power to change or modify the software and then distribute it. Internet Explorer is a closed software by Microsoft. Okay, while Linux, OpenOffice and Apache Server, all these are open source softwares. 1 terabyte is equals to how many gigabytes? So the relation between TB and GB is 1000. Only when 1000 gigabyte will come together, it will form 1 terabyte. Given below are two statements. Search engines are known as web browsers. This 189.352.250.2 is a valid IP address. So you have to tell if both statements are true or if one or both are false. So in this question, both of the statements are false because search engine are not web browsers. In one of the questions recently we saw, search engine is a particular service that help you to access the world wide web, while web browsers, they are applications. So both are not the same thing, because Google Chrome is an example of web browser and Google is a kind of a search engine. If you look at the second statement, why am I saying that this is a false statement? Because whenever you see IP address, all these numbers, they have to be in the range from 0 to 255. Okay, so it cannot be more than 255. If it is more than 255, that IP address is invalid. So because all the numbers should be in the range of 1 to 255, one digit is wrong. That is why this IP address is invalid. So both statements are false. Again, a match the following question has come. A very nice question to test your knowledge. See, in this question, it says RAM. RAM stands for Random Access Memory. So it holds the computer or programs currently being used in the computer. So A, you will have to match it with 4. DVD-ROM is Digital Versatile Disk Read-Only Memory. So it can be written only once because it is read-only memory. It is going to be 3. ALU. ALU means Arithmetic Logic Unit. So it is used for computation. So the option will be 2nd. CPU is the brain of the computer. So the answer is going to be 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's match 4, 3, 2, 1. A is the right answer to this question. Okay. In an internet world, computers are identified by IP address. IP means Internet Protocol Address. So there are certain rules for an IP address. There should be 4 digits separated by dots, and the number should be, all the digits should be in the range of 0 to 255. There are certain numbers that are reserved, but in simple terms, I would like to tell you, IP addresses are used to identify a web resource. No, any computer. IP addresses are used to identify computers or networking devices on the internet. Which of the following is a programming language? So programming language is Java. Java is one of the programming languages. Programming languages are used to write code and for the conversion of this language or this source code, you use language translator. So language translator could be a compiler or interpreter. Again, I match the following question. WWW, it stands for World Wide Web. Python is a kind of a programming language. RAM stands for random access memory and it is a volatile memory, while ROM is a non-volatile memory. So the answer should be 3412. 3412. D should be the right answer. Which description is appropriate among the following for e-governance? So e-governance, when the governance is done through the use of internet, it is called e-governance. The best description is option A, to engage, enable and empower the citizens, is the right answer. Dash represents raw facts, whereas dash is processed meaningful data. So raw facts is known as data, and when that data is processed, it is known as information. So the right answer is B. First blank should be data and the other blank should contain information. Which of the following storage devices store maximum amount of data? Floppy disk, compact disk, hard disk or magnetic optic disk? So here the answer is option C, hard disk. Nowadays we have hard disk in the range of terabytes. It can have data till more than terabyte. Okay, so this is the final question. I request you to write your scores in the comment section. Also, let us know if you like this video or not. If you like it, don't forget to click the thumbs up button. And do subscribe our channel so that you never miss an update from our channel. So we'll meet tomorrow. The second video of this mock test will be uploaded tomorrow at 8 a.m. Do watch it and let us know how you like it.